Ambassador Murphy, please tell us why you are participating in the International Symposium this year.
Well, we're a co-sponsor of this conference on Afghanistan. It's very important to us. It's one of the core and most vital security and diplomatic initiatives that we have. We share an enormous amount of common ground with Germany, one of the most important allies we have on a range of issues, and certainly in Afghanistan, certainly in the military campaign, as well as in civilian development, police training, etc. So this is an extremely important topic for us.
The term soft power is a very important term in the cultural diplomacy movement. How do you understand this term, and how can it be implemented in the international relations?
President Obama, Secretary Clinton, Secretary Gates, and others in our administration, and I have to say I feel as well passionately, that one has as its at its disposal, particularly a country of the size and scope and mass of the United States, that you've got a whole range of power alternatives at your disposal. And many of the non-military powers. Military power is, has been, is, and will continue to be a vital source of global power, let there be no question. But there is unusual impact from deployment of other elements of power, including good governance, emulation of good qualities, good habits, human rights, being seen to be a force for the good, outreach across a whole range of populations and geographies, women's rights, reconciliation with the Muslim community, which President Obama so effectively started last year. We think that you've got a whole range of, we have a whole range, any country has a whole range of alternatives available to them in addition to military power.
You mentioned a new strategy paper that was presented yesterday. Can you give us a quick outline of the Afghan regarding?
It's not really Afghan specific. It's a national security strategy, which is an annual event per our U.S. Congress. And I think the one headline I would give you is that I think President Obama quite articulately has outlined, and Secretary Clinton, I might add, in a speech at Brookings yesterday, elaborated on this also quite articulately. This, put differently, a lot of the notions that the your question on soft power begged, which is, among other things, a wrinkle that we acknowledge in our national security strategy, is that no one country can go it alone, and that includes us. We need partners, we need folks who share our values and objectives. And secondly, this point that it's not just all about military power, economic security, to pick an example, is incredibly vital for not just Americans, but for all free citizens.